Hi guys, welcome to Daily Technical Forex Forecast for the 8th of December. My name is Andrew Shineski. I'm a technical analyst at TrueForFX, and traditionally we'll begin our forecast with the EURUSD currency pair. The price continued falling yesterday, but you see that the fall of the price was smooth and it was supported by small volume, so that we can't point out any concrete volume level or zone. And if we take a look at our volume chart, we can see the proof of this statement, that you see that the chart is really like naked and volume was really small. And of course, in such a case, it's very difficult to consider new positions, as we don't have a good place for putting our stop loss. And the only scenario when we can trade this currency pair is the creation, is the appearance of large volume at creation, some new volume levels that can be used in trading and where we can put our stop losses. Until that, while volume on the market is very small, we can't trade this instrument, and it's better just to stay out of the market. The pound, very interesting situation here. The price has tested the level of support 1.3360, 1.3381. You see that it was a fake breakout, and after that the price showed a significant and sharp growth. You see that the growth price was on large volume, so it's a great bullish impulse and a great bullish signal. Of course, in such a case, we can consider the scenario of the breakout of the resistance. Moreover, the price is located near this level and the resistance is 1.3544. So scenario is pretty simple, waiting for the breakout of this level. The breakout move must be abrupt and supported by a large volume. After that, we can open long positions and wait for further growth of the price. A stop loss should be placed below the breakout volume bar. A potential of the deal is more than 120 pips. So for the pound, long positions after the breakout of the confident breakout of the level of resistance. The yen, the price also continued growing after the test of the support zone 111.45, 112.08, but as for here's situation is the same as for the euro. You see that volume on the market is very very small, so that we can't point out any volume levels or zones, and of course we don't have a place for putting our stop loss, a reliable place, and in such situation it's very difficult to trade currency pair when you don't have a good place for a stop loss. So that the scenario is pretty simple. As for the euro, we need to wait for the creation of some new volume levels that can be used for trading and that can be used as a good place for putting our stop losses, and then we can trade this currency pair. Of course, given a pretty confident growth of the price, we should give preference to long positions for the yen, but still we need to wait for the appearance of large volume on the market. The Canadian dollar, nothing has changed here. The price continued growing and now is located a little bit below the level of resistance and the maximum 1.2906. So of course we should give preference to long positions. We can enter the market after the sure and sharp breakout of the level of resistance. The breakout move must be supported by increased large volume in order to avoid fake breakouts. After that, here we open long positions. A stop loss should be placed below the breakout volume bar. A potential of the deal is up to 150 pips, so extremely profitable deal. We just need to wait for the breakout of the resistance. The Australian dollar, our scenario was totally executed as the price continued falling after the breakdown of the previous level of support, but unfortunately volume is very small on the market and it's very difficult to consider any new positions. Oh, but of course short positions should be in priority, as support was broken down and the price continued pretty confident fall. But still, it's from the current level we can't open short positions, as stop loss will be pretty large, and that's why we need to wait for a smooth upward correction on small volume, and then we can open short positions. A stop loss should be placed above the level 0.7570, And then we wait for the price. A potential Aussie deal is around 60 pips. So for the Australian dollar, short positions should be in priority. And our last instrument is gold. You see that our scenario was totally executed too. The price finally broke down the lower limit of the global consolidation, and after that it continued falling. The fall was confident, it was sharp, you can see it from the chart, but still it was on small volume. So you see that last days volume on the market is very, very small. And of course there is a reason, because today we have payrolls. But as we are talking about gold, we need to say that there is no good situation for trading right now. Yes, short position should be in priority, but stop loss will be extremely huge if we open short positions from the current level. Of course, we can wait for some correction, but really, given the fact that payrolls will be released today, this scenario is not so good. So that's why my advice for gold is just to skip this instrument from our trading plan. Let's take a look at the sentiment of the market. Well, here we can note that all our scenarios are confirmed, which is a great additional signal. So we need to wait for some good additional signals, and then we can trade almost all major currency pairs and gold. But overall, today payrolls, as I mentioned before, payrolls will be released, and I advise you to be extremely careful and close all positions before the release of the news. And we can trade, we can enter and the market and consider new positions only after the market gets calm. So only after that we can consider new positions. So extremely careful today, waiting for the release of labor market data, and then we can, I guess, new large volume will appear, and of course it will enable us to consider some new positions. So extremely careful, waiting for the payrolls, and then consider new positions. So for today's all, thank you guys for watching. Hope this forecast will be useful for you. See you next week. Bye bye.